just needed people in South Florida who I always was terrified that they would not support me, but no, everybody was, they were so behind me for my trial. It was so rewarding. I was never afraid of trial.
And judge, I gotta get your bag.
Well, that stuff's still not here.
Yeah, I wonder how long you guys are gonna be in here.
We're gonna stay for the ceremonies at 7:30.
Okay, I'm gonna go before that.
Okay.
I have to say.
Well, then.
I think you do.
I don't know. Ask Mike how we worked that out, because I don't know what to tell you.
You're just along for the ride, huh?
So how do you like Peter Hecht's book?
So anyway, yeah, the supporters had won the trial, but I was still not receiving the medical marijuana. But by then, we knew there was such a thing. And we had established state medical defense for the state of Florida. So the people just went after them and said, you give her her medicine, you're growing it without tax dollars in Mississippi, and she needs it. We've proven that in court. At the same time, the DEA's judge,
I want to see the part where
administrative law judge, like 3 weeks after my trial, told the DEA that for a government to come between a patient suffering and the benefits of this SERB was unreasonable, arbitrary, and capricious. He said that the government did not have the right to demand suffering out of patients, and that this law should be changed immediately when it came to medicine.
Oh, wonderful.
So, yeah, so that was the
And then they decided to supply you with cannabis?
We pushed them into it. My attorney also threatened to sue them because someone else that also testified at my trial, the first man ever to get medical marijuana in the United States, his name is Robert Randall. And he was totally, he told the judge his story. My story was a deja vu. So that was the beginning of a new life for me. And I didn't know anything except about the medical then. But after reading a book called The Emperor Wears No Clothes, it was a big seller in Germany about 20 years ago. I remember that. It's a book that gives you the entire history of the prohibition and how it happened and why it happened and who did it and what's happening because of it. So what the consequences have been, and I've been studying that book. I traveled with the author, I traveled with many groups of young people. I have done every state in this union, including Alaska and Hawaii, also been to Canada and Switzerland, Finland and Norway. I'm in the Netherlands, of course, watching it all grow. When I went to Norway in 97, it was like, you're telling me pollen is now, I couldn't even get anyone to even eat a cookie with me. When I went back in 03, in 02, I get out of the train station and the first thing I see is a huge cannabis leaf sticking out, not against the wall, sticking out in the middle of the street, you know, from the sidewalk, from a cannabis shop where I bought this one. So see how fast things change?
You know that I have very similar ring. I bought it. I bought it.
Goddess, of course.
God.
Of course.
It's, I've got it on a
birthday.
10 March, March 10.
Oh, nice.
It's, yeah, I will show. I just have around it, it's like little rosette, but it's handmade like that. Oh, fantastic.
But for me, finding it in Norway, 5 years after, I couldn't find anyone to smoke with me. That was quite amazing. And then the following year, they brought me back to the Million Marijuana March. Do you got anybody does this in Poland?
Yes. Yes.
I want to go next year. That would be
It would be wonderful.
Time.
It's usually in May, around 26th of May. It's Mother's Day. This is in Mother's Day. And thousands of people coming. 5,000, you know, really, really a lot. Okay. Okay. If this is your wish, I'm going to publish it on Facebook to all the, you know, to the Siege, to the networks that are, you know, for making normalization with the drug reform. And you are, you know, you are the candidate.
Thank you so much. I would be so honored to go there and do that with you. I really, I work with Dana Bill in New York, who started those global marches. And he doesn't even get all the support he would hear, but I love what happens internationally with all of us. And it's a special day to me because it's one day of the year that everybody gets together and cares about this and says, you got to change this.
Yeah. Yeah. So how many joints are you getting from U.S. government now?
I get 300 joints in a tin. Now listen, your European Union back in 03 decided that whatever you have in in your possession. If the doctor says it's your medicine, then they're not going to bother you as far as flying with your medicine. Did you know that?
No.
Don't you like to know that? That's so, in effect since September of 03. Something you should know.
This what I always thought, because like if it's just for personal use and it's not more than for 2 months, you can travel with it without any. So now they're going to put it in a law, in a writing law.
Awesome. And when I travel to Europe, I don't take as many of the government cigarettes. I concentrate it so I can take less of it. I like the hash, so I can, you know, I can use hashes. But I can get someone up wherever I am if I can.
Could I open the your box? Could I see how it? Oh, it's empty.
But, however, that's what it looks like when it's open. Oh, the same as your card.
Oh, yes. I saw that picture I saw on the internet.
Yes, that's everywhere. In fact, they have something in black and white similar to that at they used to at the Cannabis Museum in Amsterdam.
Mm-hmm.
But that was a long time ago. I don't know if they still have it.
Are you selling on eBay the packaging? I
no,
guess there will be people.
No, not at all. I don't really like to advertise. First of all, I don't sell it. What I do is friends who really want to help me in the movement, they'll give me a generous donation and I will give them a tin.
Okay.
If I have it. But I also give many of them away to museums and things like that.
Yeah, I was curious how they look. They look like regular joints.
Just, hey, wait a minute. There's all my bags are not here.
Everything you've been working for is actually starting to come through.
Yeah. Do you think there's going to be a time I can get my bags in here so I can charge my phone?
She's gone to go get it. She's left.
Oh, okay.
On her way to go get it.
All right.
She's got to get to her car and get back.
Yeah. No, I didn't know what she had said to you on her way out. Okay.
Can you charge it in here?
Yeah, but I got to get the charger.
Yeah, I got five.
This is like home.
I got 5,000 watt inverter.
Really?
There's a microwave.
Thank you so much.
So very, very much.
I brought it just for
on a travel like that, someone would definitely have to leave me because I did lose some sight after 37 years of gaming. They sent me some terrible stuff, and I lost some sight.
Oh, that's funny.
And I had to have surgery, and I had to catch retina. Nobody had touched that eye since 1953. And all because I didn't have decent marijuana.
Yeah.
And I've been taking care of it for 37 years and got it from 2,400 up to 2,160 in the sight.
No, I've been watching it. I'm not doing anything hard on it right now.
And how you feel now? How is your glaucoma?
The glaucoma is totally under control without any drops, with only marijuana, and that surgery did work for that. But unfortunately, touch my retina. Every time I have any surgery, I always lose sight because it always messes something else. I have never, ever, ever in the United States with the best of doctors, and they really are, have ever had a surgery that at the end I had better sight than before. Maybe for a few weeks I did when I got a new cornea in the right eye, but the pressures came again. I took that away. This never happened. But now, it would have, but it detached the retina, so the pressures are under control, but I lost a lot of sight, back to 2,300, and that makes me feel like I'm playing Russian roulette crossing streets. That does not make me happy. I want to see those stars again. I haven't seen them lately. And I didn't even look last night, and I probably could have seen them then.
I will hug you. The starring.
I can't wait to work with you over there.